Franchising your business is like a one in a thousand, like probably chance that it's successful. Like it is very difficult to franchise a business and get it off the ground because what happens is if usually they're gonna go, first off, you don't have the money. You think you have the money, but you don't. It costs about $100,000 all in the first year, but then you have salaries and payroll and you have to be a technology company. You have to really be savvy at bringing technology to these franchisees. And if your first franchisees don't knock it out of the park, like they're not making like tons of money, you're dead in the water.
Welcome to the Never Been Promoted podcast and YouTube channel. I'm on a mission to help you cut the tie to all the things that are holding you back so you can unleash your entrepreneur.
We're going to do another entrepreneurial journey today. It's Brigham Dallas, who's the CEO and founder of Hello Sugar. How are you doing today?
Man, I'm great. Thanks for having me on the show. Appreciate it, Thomas.
You're the founder of Hello Sugar. It's a waxing company that's like taking over the world. Do you want to take a few minutes to give a little background on you and your what your current venture is?
Yeah, sure. So background, I came from digital advertising. So numbers were kind of like my bread and butter, just spending all day in spreadsheets, Excel and Google Ads and digital stuff. So numbers was my background. I'm not passionate about waxing. I never was. I don't wax myself. And so anyways, I looked at the business. I had a friend that was, she was waxing and she had a part-time job. She was doing it for herself. And she said, yeah, I had to pay $20,000 in taxes. And I'm like, $20,000? Like how much money did you make? I thought like hair, you know, like doing like hairstylists and stuff. And she said, I made probably like $100,000 this year. She wasn't like bragging. She was complaining about the taxes, right? Like that was her thing. And I was like, tell me more, like double click on this a little bit. So she went through and she said, look, I do 4 waxes an hour, 15 minutes of Brazilian, and they're about $45 a Brazilian. And this was like almost a decade ago. And she goes, yeah, they're $45 a Brazilian. And yeah, I mean, the wax costs about $3 a wax. So I'm like, wait a minute, you make more than a lawyer. You're making $180 an hour waxing with 6 months of school. Like, how did you find your clients? And she's like, well, I did a Groupon in the beginning and people just stayed with me. And I just slowly built it from there. And I'm like, this is amazing. Like, wow, it's incredible. And so then I was doing scammy diet pill ads at the time. And I hated it. It was unethical. I didn't like it. I felt like we're lying. And I thought, not really me. So I was like, I wasn't sleeping well at night. And so I was like, I got to get out of this business. And so I started Hello Sugar. I didn't have a ton of money at the time. I was, you know, very like bootstrapping, do it as cheap as possible. And so at the time, you know, Google Ads, I had a client who was a plastic surgeon, Dr. Moshe Rafa, and he let me just put a salon in the back of his office. He had the equipment, he had the table, we had reception up front. So I just like spent about $3,000. I brought this person down from another state to train. She spent one day training my first employee and I opened a waxing salon.
Tell me about your hirings. What are the things you really look for in honesty, an employee?
Yeah, let's kind of talk through that for a second. I think every entrepreneur needs to know how much it costs to hire somebody. So our cost today is $1,500. So by the time we take somebody in the door, we hire them, we go through the interview process, plus training them to become a waxing professional, it's about $1,500. And I'm on the low side. I think probably it's closer to $2,000 when you put in intangibles, but let's say $1,500. So if you get it wrong and you have to terminate within 3 months, that costs you $1,500. So a year and a half ago, I went through Predictive Index, just like this personality test. There's a lot of them out there, but this one's specific to job professionals. And it costs me $12,000 a year. And it comes with a consultant and we build this profile of what we're looking for in an esthetician. And the thought process on this is, you know, I've got maybe 80 to 100 employees and I'm hiring probably like 5 to 10 a month, right? So if I could just find like 12, like maybe like 8 more employees that are good this time around because of this test, then I'm really like, it's like working for me, right? And it's like worth it. So our hiring process is unique. We first do a personality test. If they don't pass the criteria for somebody in our personality group, and for us, we know our customers want to feel comfortable, right? Like that's the main thing. You're naked, exposed on a table. You want to feel comfortable with the person waxing you.
How much in your world though, do you consider the things that you probably can't talk about? How they look, how they appear, smell, things like that aren't on the job application. And I say hire deeply. Some of these things are around a brand. So how do you handle those teams, if at all, in your business?
Yeah, you know, my perception of this has like did a 180 since I started. So when I started, I was like looking at European Wax, which is a big competitor. And they take like a high fashion profile. Fashionista is their like demographic, beauty. I'm like cool on the runway kind of like branding. And so I thought they would hire estheticians that were like models, right? And so I was like, okay, we got to hire the prettiest, best like looking people, because that's what, that give the people what they want, right? And it turns out that is like the worst thing you could do in my industry, right? Because if you're like this supermodel, you know, you're like Reese Witherspoons and you have somebody come in, facts. Females all think that they're not pretty. They look at every single flaw about them, imperfection, and they're like, they're not pretty. My wife's like this.
Don't hire based on an image, hire on a function. And your brand is more than how someone looks. It's more about how I was treated, how I feel, and what I got done for me. And so when did you decide to franchise? Maybe give some closing advice of, I think you've said it, but like, you know, here are the three things. If you're going to do this, something like this, start small, do this. But then if you're going to franchise, what was the next piece?
I ran 5 years by myself. So 5 years without franchising. I built, I think, 8 or 9 stores at that point. Yeah, I think it was 9 stores. Some were suites, some were flagships. Flagships being like a 1200 square foot, like in next adjacent to like a grocery store, kind of like the typical boutique you would see. And at the time I was teaching at a university, a class on how to start small businesses through advertising. That was my calling in life, was just helping people start businesses. And I really had a passion for it. And I said, you know what, this is kind of what I want to do in the future. And I really love my business. So why don't I franchise and I can help other people start a really good concept and grow this business? You know, the unit economics are good. Let's try it out. And what I know now about franchising versus what I knew then, I just thought, hey, cool, I'll just franchise, people will start. And it's like, okay, franchising your business is like a 1 in 1,000, like probably chance that it's successful. Like, it is very difficult to franchise a business and get it off the ground. Because what happens is, if usually they're gonna go, first off, you don't have the money. You think you have the money, but you don't. It costs about $100,000 all in the first year, but then you have salaries and payroll, and you have to be a technology company. You have to really be savvy at bringing technology to these franchisees. And if your first franchisees don't knock it out of the park, like they're not making like tons of money, you're dead in the water. And so it's a lot of luck too. Like, did you pick the right cities to go into, the right territories to go into? And so I franchised, I spent $25,000 on my like legal documents the first year. And then I started with 2 people in my like network that were like estheticians or like receptionists in the company. And I paid for their franchises. So I built them and I just said, hey, go out and do your thing. I'm going to pay for it. Let's just see what happens. It's a loan. You can pay me back.
And now fast forward now. So you have like, I think you said 79 locations and more coming. Are you doing all the origination for franchise owners yourself? Are you using consultants and paying them a fee to find them for you?
No. No fees, no consultants. We're doing everything in-house. I think our brand is good enough that we don't have to find consultants to do this. So yeah, kind of fast forward. So that was year one and I just had my friends do it. So I just opened it up to my own network, and every single time we got a little bit better and I was fully transparent with everybody. Like, these are my friends. I'm like, look, this is going to suck. This is going to be hard, but I believe in the future, you're going to be very successful because of this. And all the people that started in the beginning, I believe are very close to being millionaires at this point, or like, they're like on that track. Their net worth is over $1 million, but maybe they're not cash in the bank $1 million yet. But they're doing awesome. Like, I'm very proud of them. The second year, you know, we have like actual FDD, which is like published numbers called the item 19, where you publish things. We published everything. So we published the profit and loss statements of the bad ones, the good ones. I mean, it was like fully transparent. And we just went to town and we just started, you know, reaching out to networks, you know, friends of friends, that kind of stuff, started building it. And then the year three, which is, I guess this is year three. I mean, it was 2021. Now we're in 2024. So I guess we're really in year three. So in 2 years, we grew to 79 locations. I mean, we just exploded in growth in this time period because it's profitable. It works well. And I think the other thing that, one last thing on this, Thomas, I think the other thing that made it so compelling is that we don't do the big model like everybody else. We do salon suites just like I started my first location. So we do a salon suite. It costs $60,000 to put up. And according to our FDD, which is the only thing I can talk about in this, I can't legally say anything else, the average unit is making $67,000 profit after the first year. And the top quartile making $110,000 profit on a $60,000 investment with 5 to 10 hours a week of time put into this. Take that location, you build it, prove the business model, then you get a loan, find a flagship, which is that 1200 square foot place. You take a year of your life to build it out, cost maybe $200,000 to $350,000 is like averaged for these things. And you're making profits the whole time from your suite. So you're never in a down place. Then you close your suite and move into the flagship. And now you've got this big unit that's making $150,000 to $250,000, which are the averages of the flagships, in profit. And it's successful without losing sleep, knowing if it's not going to work or not.